Hi guys, someone suggested quite rightly that I should do a quick fire questions on physics equations. Now obviously this varies from exam board to exam board, but it is essential for a lot of you out there that you've got all these physics equations learnt because they're being more mean and they're not really providing many equations on the physics equation sheet. So because you're all doing different exam boards, the way I recommend you use this video is to get hold of your textbook or a printout of the equations that you'll be given in the exam, and then just refer to that so that when I ask one, double check and see if you actually need to practice it or if you're just going to be given it, because that would be a waste of your time. But let's just dive straight in. Now, remember when I've always told you to use the triangle method when doing your physics equations, because what it enables you to do is to learn one thing but have three equations out of it. So one of my favourite triangle memory techniques is drunk men vomit, and that's for density equals mass over volume. So you write in your exam the triangle DMV with D at the bottom, you cover the D, and that will tell you that D is M divided by V, you cover the M and mass is therefore density times volume, you cover the V and therefore volume is mass divided by density, and that's why I like triangles so much. Anyway, let's get started with the first question I'm going to ask. So how do you calculate speed? So speed equals distance divided by time. How do you calculate acceleration? Well, that's change in speed or change in velocity over time. How do you calculate force? Force is mass times acceleration. How do you calculate weight? Weight equals mass times gravitational field strength, which on Earth is just a number, which is 10 or 9.8 if you're feeling more accurate. How do you calculate momentum? Momentum equals mass times velocity. What's the equation for moments? Moment equals force times perpendicular distance from the pivot. How do you calculate force when we're talking about momentum? So force equals change in momentum over time. What's the equation for calculating power? And now there are lots of different equations, but this is I'm going to just use the one that I know. So that's PIV, so power equals current times voltage. Either write these words out in full, by the way, or use the correct scientific symbols. Remember, current is given by an I, not a C. How do you calculate voltage? Voltage equals current times resistance. How do you calculate charge? Charge is given by current times time. Remember to use your SI units, so time should be in seconds unless otherwise stated. How do you calculate wave speed? Wave speed equals frequency times wavelength. Remember, wavelength is given by lambda, which is that weird Greek symbol. How do you calculate the refractive index? That equals sine I over sine R, and remember, refractive index is given by the letter N, so N equals sine I over sine R. How do you calculate the critical angle? That's sine C equals 1 over N, so 1 over the refractive index. Remember, when you're doing these calculations, you're going to have to inverse that sine. How do frequency and time period relate? Remember, frequency is 1 over time period. What's the equation for calculating efficiency? Well, that's useful energy output over total energy input times by 100, because we tend to give it as a percentage. How do you calculate work done? Work done is force times distance. And remember, work done and energy are the same thing. So therefore, how do you calculate energy? Well, it's force times distance. What's the equation for gravitational potential energy? That is GPE equals MGH, so mass times gravitational field strength times height. I don't recommend you use a triangle for this one. And same with the next example. How do you calculate kinetic energy? Well, kinetic energy equals half mv squared, so that's half of mass times velocity squared. Be prepared to rearrange those equations, but don't use the triangle method to actually learn them. What's the equation for power? And not to do with electricity, the other power equation. That's energy transferred over time. We've already done this one, but let's do density again. So what's the equation for density? density equals mass over volume. What's the equation for pressure? Pressure equals force over area. And then what's the equation for pressure difference? And you're going to have to do density times gravitational field strength times height. Now we're looking at Boyle's law, so we're looking at how pressure and volume interlink. So what's the equation linking pressure and volume? P1V1 equals P2V2. What about the equation linking pressure and temperature? Remember, that's P1 over T1 equals P2 over T2. Crucial thing to remember here is that temperature needs to be in kelvins rather than Celsius. Looking at magnetism, what's the equation linking voltage and number of turns? That is input voltage over output voltage equals number of turns on the primary coil over number of turns on the secondary coil. What's the equation linking voltage and current in the magnetism topic? Well, that's voltage primary times current primary equals voltage secondary times current secondary. What's the equation linking power, current and resistance? This will only be applicable to certain exam boards. And that is power equals current squared times voltage. What about the force applied to a spring? So we're looking at Hooke's law here. So force applied to the spring equals spring constant times extension. There might be a sneaky Suvat question. So what's the equation linking final velocity, initial velocity, acceleration, and distance travelled? And that's v squared minus u squared equals 2as, where v squared is the final velocity, u squared is the initial velocity, a is the acceleration, and s is the distance. Another weird one, magnification, which tends to be more of a biology topic, but it might sneak up in physics. So I use the triangle I am, so I at the top, A at the bottom, M at the bottom for this. Therefore, magnification is given by, I've probably told you the answer rather than asking the question, but I'm sure it's helpful anyway. So you're going to say magnification is image size divided by actual size of object. Therefore, what is the actual size of the object? So that's going to be the image size divided by the magnification. Right, I hope that was helpful for you guys. I know everyone's example is different. I hope I covered most of the equations there and it was helpful to you. And I'll be back soon with another video.